So tonight I'm having a kind of little goodbye party type thing, and yeah, I'm gonna make some profiteroles rolls now, and I'm gonna have lots of food, and we're hoping to play werewolf. We might not have enough, but we're gonna try and make it work because it's a fun game. And so yeah, that's today. I'm leaving in just over a week, which is crazy. I have been up and down, like, it's, I want to go, but like sometimes I'm just like, oh my god, why am I doing this? What is happening? It's just crazy, but yeah, I'm a mixture of emotions right now. I'm excited, I'm scared, I'm nervous, I'm just like, it's crazy. But yeah, that's just over a week now, which is just, it's flying by so fast. I think the last time I updated you guys in this video was like nearly a month ago in London, I think. Yeah, so that's crazy. So I've done these profiteroles once before, and I think I wrote a blog post on it, so I'll link that below. I think I did, because the first time I did it, like, I've only done it once, but the first time I did it within that day, I don't know what it was, but I made a mistake. I think I probably wrote about it in my blog. And so then I had to do, like, start again. But this time hopefully it'll go okay. I'm really reading the instructions really well. It's Tanya Burr, Tanya Bakes book. So that's the recipe. Instead of melted chocolate, I'm gonna do ganache, and I might even try and pipe ganache into some profiteroles. So we'll see how that works out. But yeah, profiteroles are delicious. So I was like, it's a dessert I don't do often enough, and you know, why not give it a go?
Looking good so far.
One more tray left to come out. I had to make a few mini ones because I was scared that I didn't have enough room and I had so much batter. So I just made a few mini ones, but now I know that I can probably put them tighter together than I did. They look good. I tasted some, and I tasted some mini ones, and they're really, really nice and tasty. So the ones that I just took out have a few more cracks in them than the others, but I think that's because they were at the bottom of the oven and they just didn't cook as quickly, and then when I opened the oven to get the other ones out, they were, you know, not completely ready. So, but I think that's okay. Like, they're decent enough. I think they'll be fine. They look good. So I've done ganache a lot of times before, but today I'm trying out Yolanda Gamp's recipe. I think I'm only gonna do half because I'm obviously not covering a cake. And so, I don't know. It says it makes 3 cups worth, so I don't know if that's too much ganache or not. Let's get cracking on making the ganache and the cream, whipped cream. I think I'm gonna make the whipped cream first, because that way it's done and the ganache isn't waiting around. So yeah, let's do this. For the whipped cream, I'm just gonna do half the amount that it says in Tanya's book, because I wanna do, put some ganache filling as well in some profiteroles. So let's get whipping. So, Maureen is here.
Hello.
Miriam's here. Roisin's here.
And my blog appropriate. My lipstick everywhere. I feel like it's everywhere.
So, we just tried Werewolf, and it was, I mean, we got through one round and that was it.
Yeah.
It was fun. We had fun though, because we were just laughing.
I made people fall in love, and that's what I come here at parties to do.
Yeah. That was a terrible liar.
She was the werewolf.
And the little girl.
And then,
and I was the witch and yeah. Sheriff.
And townsfolk, yeah. Mm-hmm. No, I was moderator, but like, it didn't work. But like, it was fun because it was so like, not working that It was funny.
Entertaining.
It was, yeah, we just couldn't stop laughing. I couldn't stop laughing because I knew who everyone was, and then so I was just like laughing at all the things that wouldn't work. Ooh, that's very nice. Huh?
Sorry, I think I might have just recorded
it. So I got this really cool present from Miriam as kind of like a birthday gift, a belated birthday gift. It's so cool. It's highlighters and lip glosses that like, I can kind of use as like highlighters for my lips, I guess. And then such a beautiful little card. Look at her handwriting. It's just so pretty. So it was a really, really nice night. It's like past midnight now. I think it's like, yeah, it's like 10 to 1. But it was a really, really nice evening. I can never go to bed straight away after these things, no matter how tired I am. After doing something or after getting back from somewhere, or just after being so like energetic or like, I don't know, I can never go to bed straight away. And then I had to tidy up and stuff. But I'm really tired now. I'm gonna get ready for bed, take my makeup off, all that jazz. And yeah, it's getting real. Now only like, just, yeah, a week and a day. Well, like, cause it's technically Sunday, so a week and a day till I leave, which is crazy. Oh my gosh. So I'm just tidying through my bags to see what ones I'm gonna bring, and look what I found. This was my first ever handbag. How cute. Oh my god, I remember the day I got this for one of my birthdays. I can't remember which year it was, but I was so excited. I was like, oh my god, I got my first handbag. Like, oh, so cute. This bag is from Nicaragua. I got this at an Operation Smile conference, the one I know it was in Ireland in 2014. And it was like, it's the iParty where they sell stuff from all the different countries. And so I got this bag from Nicaragua. It's really pretty. Just don't know if I'm going to bring it because I just can't bring everything, obviously. So Roisin wants to do this kind of like little brunchy lunchy type thing with me before I go. So that's where I'm off to right now. I'm going to meet her in like a pizzeria. And I'm hoping they have like non-pizza stuff there too, because I had pizza last night and we're gonna have more pizza tonight because it's leftovers. So I am gonna miss living in Ireland, but I'm excited to live in London. I'm nervous and scared. I'm mixed emotions, like I said, but I am excited, so here's to a new adventure. It's actually feeling really surreal today. Like, I'm not really moving in a week, am I? Like, it just doesn't feel real right now. And some days it feels real, some days it feels really weird and not real, but like it's not happening. I will be moving to London. Wow. Like, craziness. But yeah, I'm gonna miss Ireland, Dublin, where I live, being near the beach, but at least I have something nice to come back to when I visit home, so yeah. Hi.
Hello.
It is 3 days until I move now, and I thought I'd give you guys a quick little room tour. We've been packing all day. So I have been looking for this necklace since Budapest. I wanted to bring it with me and wear it then, and I couldn't find it anywhere. I wanted black lace-up boots, found them. These posters have been up there for like God knows how long. I'm leaving tomorrow. It still doesn't feel real to me.